Start my second lecture, but before that, let me recapitulate the important concept that I discussed in my last lecture. After the brief introduction, I discussed diodes, the very important parameter in high frequency conversion is, one is the reverse recovery current and the reverse recovery time. These two are very important. Okay. How these parameters are used in design process, I will discuss at the appropriate time. Let me cover DC to DC conversion, let me and DC to AC conversion, and when we are doing design of these converters towards the end, I will tell you how to take care of these parameters. Okay. Then I discuss about a BJT. Generally NPN types are popular. Okay. Though these BJTs are not very popular, they were popular in the 80s. I wanted you to appreciate, in order to appreciate MOSFET and IGBT, one need to know BJT. Okay. The problem with the BJT is, we found that as the power rating increases, the gain decreases. Basically, BJT is a current fed device. So that if the gain comes down, the base current required to drive the BJT increases. So therefore, in my control circuit or in my base drive circuit, I may require, I may require a small power transistor to drive another power transistor. Basically, BJT is a current fed device and gain falls as the power rating increases. So generally the BJT is operated in quasi saturation region. See, BJT has an excellent output characteristics. Output characteristics in the sense, during conduction I can reduce or I can control the on state voltage drop. I can reduce it, I can bring down to as low as VC is at. Okay. Fine, my switching frequency may come down, that is the secondary issue, but then it is possible to reduce the on state conduction on state losses. The problem with BJT is it is a current fed device and I require a large gate drive current. Okay. Now let us see another device which is very popular, is especially in DC to DC conversion, is MOSFET, power MOSFET. In 1978, 25 ampere power MOSFET invented. As of now, see the current rating, 200 volt, 500 ampere, semicron MOSFETs are available, 60 volts, 1000 ampere by semicron, these are available. See, low voltage, high current, generally MOSFETs are used in relatively low voltage and high current application, basically they are very fast devices. Very popular in DC-DC conversion, MOSFET stands for metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Very fast device, it is a majority carrier device, okay. Yeah, like BJT is again a non-latching device, I need to have a continuous gate drive, but what sort of a gate drive, we will see. The three terminals that we use in a BJT is base emitter collector, whereas in MOS is drain, source and gate. Okay. And gate signal is generally applied between gate and source. See the structure, we have an N plus, highly doped, N minus, lightly doped, P junction and N plus junction, gate, source and drain. Now let us see, we will start from current flow is from drain to source, we will start from drain to source, let us see what happens. There is a N, okay. P. So, see here, D terminal is here, N, cathode of a diode, there is an anode here, then again PN, again PN, and we reach the source. So, if you see two diodes, if I just see the structure, there are two diodes are connected back to back. So, looks like there cannot be a current flow. If I just see the structure, because two diodes are connected back to back, then, but then MOSFETs are do used in DC to DC conversion, but therefore it has to conduct. So how is that possible? Now let's see what happens when I apply a suitable biasing voltage. Gate is insulated from the rest of the device. I'm telling gate is insulated from the rest of the device. So therefore there is no steady state current, something equivalent to a parallel plate capacitor, okay. So only a displacement current can flow like a parallel plate capacitor. So MOSFET is in cutoff when gate to source voltage is less than the threshold value. Again, this threshold value one need to see from the data sheet. Depending upon the voltage and power level, this value does change. But then when the applied voltage VGS is greater than the threshold value, okay, what happens is this. A small channel is formed between, it and source, okay, a channel, okay. Once the channel is formed, the electron starts flowing and therefore the current, okay. When the applied voltage is higher than the gate to threshold value, channel is formed, electron starts flowing and therefore the current. So on conduction or during conduction, how does the MOSFET look like? It's like a flow of water through pipe. It faces only the resistance. So therefore, during conduction, MOSFET appears as if it is a resistive element. So on state losses are ID square, ID is the drain current, into RDS on, drain to source resistance, RDS on. Okay. So if I compare BJT and MOSFET during conduction mode, on state losses in a MOSFET are slightly higher, because I told you it is appears as a purely resistive element, RDS on. Okay. So if I draw the ohmic, the VI characteristic, they look something like this, something similar to a BJT, active, and this region is known as the ohmic region. Okay. V and I is approximately a straight line, approximately a straight line. The slope of this is the RDS on. Okay. So generally we operate the MOSFET in this zone. See here on state, the channel of the device behaves like a resistance is RDS on. It is the slope of VDS divided by delta VDS divided by delta ID. Conduction, during conduction, conduction power loss is given by ID squared into RDS on. So looks like for a given power level, if I use a BJT, on state power losses are slightly less. So in other words, output state of a BJT is slightly superior compared to that of a MOSFET. Okay. Now what happens to the input stage? In other words, the driver circuit. I told you here the structure looks, gate and source are isolated. There is gate is insulated from the rest of the device, insulated. So if I apply a potential across it, only the displacement current can flow, something similar to a parallel plate capacitor. So how do I turn it on? By suitably applying a voltage across a gate to source. In other words, I have to charge the gate to source capacitance. Okay, I'll repeat, I have to charge the gate to source capacitance. So input impedance at the gate source is tends to infinity. So in other words, I require a very small steady state current, very small, practically negligible. It is a voltage driven device. It is not a voltage fed device, it is not a current fed device, unlike a BJT. Okay. So how do I increase the turn on time of a BJT? I said turn on time of a BJT can be decreased by supplying a high pulse of base current during turn on. So during turn on period, you supply a high pulse current, whereas in a MOSFET faster that I charge the capacitor, or faster I charge the capacitor between gate to source, faster is the turn on. Okay. So by the way, how do I charge the capacitor at a very fast rate? So maybe I need to supply initially a pulse current. That current has to flow from the control circuit. Fortunately, that is only during starting, just the charging of the capacitor, that is very small. Of course, one way, how do I charge this capacitor? Suppose I have, see here, I have a problem. If I take gate and source, so if this is a voltage source, the rate at which I charge this capacitor will determine the T on. So of course I need to connect a very small resistance to limit the starting current, otherwise current is limited by the so called the internal resistance of this voltage source. Okay, so the value of this R, external R, will determine the charging rate. Smaller the resistance, faster is the turn on. Okay, but the smaller the resistance, higher is the peak pulse current that has to flow through this source and this maybe a switch. Of course, these switches are generally realized by gates, so you need to take care of while selecting this R. Maybe sometime later I will discuss the gate drive circuit and how to choose this value of R. Okay, all right. So gate drive requirement for a MOSFET is very minimal compared to, or the power rating of the gate drive circuit for a MOSFET is very small compared to that of a BJT. Okay, basically it so happens that it is a voltage fed device and BJT happens like a current fed device. Okay, by the way, if you see the structure here, there is a inherent body diode between drain and source. Okay, something like this. If you see the structure, the MOSFET has a built-in body diode, but then what is being done is the speeds are not very comparable with that of a MOSFET. So generally an external body diode during fabrication this diode is incorporated there, so have the characteristic similar to that of a MOSFET. Okay, safe operating area of a MOSFET, I said, is a majority carrier device, so therefore it has a positive resistance coefficient. In other words, as the temperature increases, resistance increases. Okay, so therefore paralleling is easy compared to that of a BJT. BJT paralleling is difficult because it is a minority carrier device and it has a negative resistance coefficient. And if I see the safe operating area for BJT, there are four zones. They are current limit, voltage limit, power limit, and the fourth one is the secondary breakdown. Secondary breakdown is due to the negative resistance coefficient. Whereas the secondary breakdown is absent in MOS. There are only three zones: current limit, voltage limit, and this is the junction temperature limit. Okay, just show you some of the parameters of a MOSFET IRF 640. See, for a drain current of 18 amperes, RDS on is of the order of 0.18 ohms. Okay, so on state power loss is, assuming that drain current is 18 amperes, of course 18 is the rated current, we may not be able to supply that 18, it may not be able to carry 18 amperes during normal conditions. Okay, so IDS square, 18 square into RDS on, so that is the on state power loss, and one has to choose the heat sink accordingly. Now see here, the gate to threshold voltage, turn it on, is of the order of plus or minus 20 volts to turn it on and to turn it off. See the, here the timings, turn on delay 14 nanoseconds, rise time 51 nanoseconds, turn off delay 45 nanoseconds, and fall time is of the order of 36 nanoseconds. You just compare, yesterday I did, I think I gave you the characteristics of a 8 ampere BJT, and today you compare, I am discussing a 18 ampere MOSFET. And compare the timings, turn on delays, they are in terms of in nanoseconds. And see here, gate to source charge is 13 nanocoulombs. From there you can calculate the capacitance and therefore the current that is required to charge that capacitance. So if I compare the difference between a MOSFET and a BJT, current control device is a voltage control device, minority carrier device is a majority carrier device. Therefore, negative resistance and a positive resistance coefficient, has secondary breakdown, no secondary breakdown, paralleling is difficult, paralleling is easy, on state power loss Vc sat into Ic is low, Id squared Rds on is higher than on state loss of BJT, turn off time is higher because if I saturate it, that is what is known as a storage time plus the fall time. Okay. Whereas it is a very fast device. Gate dry requirement as minimum in MOSFET, and here much higher compared to in BJT is much higher compared to a MOS. So the problem with the MOS is the on state power loss. Is there a way out? Yes. What if there is, what is known as a cool MOS, as the name suggests, it has a very low on state resistance. Conduction losses are very low. But then they are very expensive. So that is about MOSFET. So we have discussed BJT and MOSFET. BJT seem to be having excellent output characteristics, you know, the okay, or the on state power loss seem to be low, but then gate drive requirement is high, whereas MOS seem to have an excellent input characteristics. Input impedance at the gate is really tends to infinity. So gate drive requirement is minimum there, but then during conduction on state power losses are high. So what could be an ideal device? According to me, the ideal device is a device which is having the input characteristics similar to that of a MOS and output characteristics similar to that of a BJT. So therefore, hence the name insulated gate bipolar transistor, an IGBT, insulated gate, something similar to MOSFET, output is a BJT, bipolar junction transistor. Okay. I said in insulated gate, in MOS structure, current is only due to the majority carrier device. Okay. But then in BJT, sorry, in IGBT, BT stands for bipolar junction transistor. So there is going to be, I need to modify the existing MOS structure. So what price that am I paying, we will see. Okay. By the way, this was invented by Jayant Baliga in 1983. Okay. Here is the structure of an IGBT. I have added or there is another P structure here, a P layer, N plus, N minus, P plus, N minus. This is the MOS structure, there is another additional P layer, P plus. So what happens when I apply a suitable gate to source voltage here? What will happen? Now holes start moving towards N, okay. Electron starts flowing to N minus region, that is, so therefore N minus layer receives electrons from N plus as well as holes from P plus. Some of them recombine and remaining electrons are collected at the source. So junctions of holes are injected to N minus region, some electrons combine with the holes, remaining holes are collected at the source. Okay. Now because of this P structure, we have a P plus and a N plus structure, so junction J1 now can block a negative voltage. Come on, listen, this voltage, if I apply a negative voltage, it can this junction J1, if I connect drain to a negative of the source and if I make source positive, this junction gets reverse biased and therefore it can block a negative voltage, can block a negative voltage. But then if you see the structure, I have a P plus and a N plus. So plus indicates is a highly doped, so therefore the reverse breakdown voltage of this junction is relatively low, relatively low. Okay, so the VI characteristics, something similar to that of BJT. Okay, but then we had a, but then control parameter is the gate current. Here it is a VGS, gate to source voltage. This is for the comparison between IGBT and a MOS. See the modified structure. See the slope of this line and the slope of this line. So on state losses in IGBT are slightly less compared to that of a MOS. By the way, coming back to the structure, do I require this N plus layer? What if I, or what happens if you remove this N plus layer? It will still work like an IGBT. Same thing, P, N, P, N. Now there is P plus N plus N minus P plus N minus. So if I, so if there is no N plus layer, I have only P plus and N minus. N minus indicates is a lightly doped. So if that is the case, this junction J1 can block a higher voltage. Now due to this N plus layer, this J1 cannot block a higher voltage. So N plus layer between P plus and N minus drift is not essential for operation of an IGBT. Some have just N minus layer. So those are known as non-punch NPT IGBTs. So if both are present, N plus as well as N minus are present, they are known as punch through IGBTs, punch through IGBTs. But then what are the advantages of NPT and PT? So non-punch through, wherein there is no N plus, it can block a higher voltage. Now so it is almost symmetrical, both it can block positive as well as negative voltage. It is what is known as a symmetrical device, symmetrical device. Whereas if there is a N plus layer, it can block a higher voltage in the positive when it is forward biased, and it can block a smaller voltage when it is reverse bias. So it is a non-symmetrical device. So in other words, NPT, you may be able to use it in AC, okay, supply, but then a punch through you cannot use it. Okay. So see the structure here, there is no N plus here, this is N plus. So this is a symmetrical device, both it can block positive as well as negative voltage. This device cannot block negative voltage because of this junction, or if at all if it blocks, it is a very small voltage. Now turn on and turn off an IGBT. Okay. Turn off mode, turn on something similar to that of a MOS. Now turn off. There is a MOS as well as a BJT in an IGBT, both are combined. There are two distinct turn off intervals during turn off. Okay, see here, drain current and gate to source voltage, we are reducing it. So first the channel, the MOSFET, the current due to the MOSFET effect reduces. Okay, the channel disappears quickly, MOSFET blocks. Okay, but then this is due to the majority carriers, but then minority carriers in N minus layer gradually recombine. Okay, that is something known as the BJT current, or what is known as the tail current. It takes, see, minority trapped in N minus layer, they gradually combine. It takes significant time to recombine, or this process is relatively slow. Okay, but then the voltage across the device starts increasing. So during this period of BJT current, what is known as the tail current, voltage across the device has increased. It is in the process of blocking mode. Okay, voltage is high, current is still finite, so there is going to be a substantial, a significant power loss during turn off. So tail current is a very important parameter, and that determines the turn off process. Okay, so ID is relatively slow. Known as the train current voltage, this period should be very small, since VDS has attained reasonably a high value. Okay, losses are high, but then this time punch through IGBT has a smaller tail time. Why? There is an n plus layer, n minus layer, the minority carriers are trapped, it takes time to recombine, but then here the concentration is high, so therefore it takes lesser time to recombine. Okay, so tailed current tail, or this TF, fall time, is relatively smaller in case of punch through BJT, punch through IGBT. Just see the time, storage time, something similar to that of a BJT. MOSFET current has reduces faster, and this current take its own time. This process is there in almost all the devices, even is there in GTO. I have not covered GTO because I do not think the GTO is on this way out, or it is, by the way, it is not very popular, that is the reason I have not covered. Safe operating area IGBT, that is about it. Finally, the smart power modules. They have the entire bridge, driver circuit, as well as protection circuit. Just the power modules, if there are only power module, I need to design a driver circuit as well as the protection circuit. All this protection circuit have to be designed in the gate driver itself. Okay, whereas a smart power module, everything is incorporated or during the fabrication. So size of the entire power electronic equipment reduces significantly. So once such IPM is, all the terminals, protection, gate drive circuit are brought out. These are three output terminals, plus, minus, and the driver terminals. They are brought out in smart modules. So that's about devices. We started from one device, single three-legged element, to power modules, okay, and from there to a smart power modules. There is a significant reduction in size, and therefore the space that occupied by these devices. That's about the devices. I'll take up few questions.
Okay, regarding IPM modules, where we can get the smaller power modules in India?
No, we have to import them. There are Indian agents. Maybe I will.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Amrita Coimbatore, please go ahead with your question.
Sir, I just want to ask regarding the resistance which is used to limit the starting current when we are trying to charge the gate source capacitance.
Yes, I will cover this at the appropriate time. See, that's the reason you need to pay a price. You have to see the data sheet and you have to find out from there. See here, I need to charge this. Now you need to tell me, how do I charge this capacitor at a very fast rate? Gate and source, assume that there is a capacitor. In fact, there is one. I need to charge this at a very fast rate. Ideal condition is R tends, this external resistance tends to 0. Are you with me? Now take for example, this is a voltage source. I need to charge this capacitor. Okay. Now, smaller the resistance, faster the turn on, faster the charging time. Smaller the resistance, faster is the charging, and therefore faster the turn on. Smaller the resistance, higher is the current. This switch and the source has to supply. This source may be able to supply, but then this switch that I have to realize through gates may not be able to supply that much of current. So we need to see how much is the capacitance here and what sort of a gate or the driver circuit, what sort of a buffer that I am using, and based on that we can decide. Hang on for some time. I did tell you that during design time I will tell you how to choose this value of R. I did tell you that, yeah, I will tell you. In the sense, if you are using a gate, that then you need to find out the fan out or fan in capacity of the BJT of those gates. Or what you can do is, I have a gate buffer, then maybe a small, this is a buffer, then maybe a small signal transistor, a small signal transistor, and then connect a small suitable resistor and this. I can directly connect a buffer to or through a small resistor here to a capacitor. If this is not able to supply this current, okay, you use a small signal transistor and thereby put a resistor and this. You need to choose a first I need to know the type of MOS, various capacity, current carrying capacity of this, and only then we can decide this value of R. One has to see the data sheets. I will do this. I will take a typical example and solve it in the class. Don't worry.
Sir, we know very well about BJTs and MOSFET. Nowadays, light activated SCR is in market. If we use that light activated SCR for the reception of the radiation from the solar radiation, or is there any plan in future to produce SCR triac diac those devices for power electronic applications?
See, I don't know in the sense what happens in the future, I do not know, but then one thing is for sure, SCR is a basically an ideal device. I don't require a continuous gate drive, my continuous, just a pulse I require, just a sharp pulse during turn on. So my entire gate drive circuit, the size of the gate drive circuit reduces significantly if I come, okay. Unfortunately, when I convert it to AC, I need to have a grid there for commutating the SCR, line commutation. So otherwise, in a DC to DC conversion, I can't use SCR. If I use, then I have to use force commutation. So therefore, they are not being used. That's precise reason we don't even teach force commutation circuit in the class also. I do not know, an ideal device could be, yes, turning off, see, having a device which can be turned on by just by a pulse, okay, and turn off using gate. I do not know, time will tell. Time will tell whether such devices will come.
Vijayawada.
Have shown that the source and substrate are connected, whereas in schematic you have shown that the drain is connected to the body. Which one is the right test?
Which one?
Though there is no difference between, as for the geometries, there will be no difference between source and drain.
Huh.
Normally, source will be shorted to
substrate. See, it is a channel. No. Listen, it is a channel. It is a bipolar. It can conduct in both directions. You have to suitably apply a gate drive signal. And therefore, MOS can carry current in both directions, no issues, depending upon the biasing. Depending upon the biasing, current can from source to drain, both it is possible. But then you need to apply suitable gate signals. So the flow, it is the flow of electrons or the direction during conduction. I said a channel is formed and the electrons start flowing. It is something similar to that of a water flow through a pipe. So current can flow in both the directions, no issues.
Shivaji University, Kolhapur, please go ahead with your question.
Will you relate the two diode structure of MOSFET with the diagram what we have shown?
That is just from the structural point of view. Once you apply a gate to source signal, that structure is not valid. I told you a channel is formed and flow of currents starts. Where is that? See here, this is the structure. Starts from N to source, N, P, PN. So if I just look at the structure, yes, there cannot be a power flow, there cannot be a current flow. But then things change when I apply a suitable voltage at the gate to gate, between gate and source. Above the threshold, a channel formed, and therefore a current starts flowing. If I just look at the structure, yes, there cannot be a current flow because there are two diodes connected back to back.
Sir, generally this N plus is used for low resistance connection.
N plus is a highly doped, only the doping level.
Yes, yes. Drain where it is connected to the drain. But it is used generally used as a low resistance connection part.
Okay, so what?
then that side what we have shown that is P and N plus packet on.
How does it matter with, see I can show only one layer, doesn't matter. See, N minus will determine, or the thickness of N minus will determine the voltage rating.
Yes, KJ Soumya, please go ahead with your question.
There is an inbuilt body diode on the MOSFET, no? So if reverse current has to flow through, what it will flow, through the diode or through the structure?
That depends on what exactly you want. It depends on the voltage, when the diode, the voltage drops of the diode or the voltage drop across the MOSFET. Are you with me? Diode also can carry current, the MOSFET also carry current. Okay? Now it all depends on the supply voltages, power loss across, or power loss during the conduction period of the diode, and power loss during the conduction of MOS. That will determine whether you want to operate, whether you want to make diode to conduct or to make MOSFET to conduct. It's entirely up to you. It's entirely up to you. If you do not apply suitable gate signal, diode will carry current, diode will start carrying current, and you apply suitably bias the gate, MOSFET will start conducting current. Are you with me? You can make diode, if there is no gate current and there is a current flow, that current diode starts conducting. And if you apply, in order to reduce the losses, if you want to make the BJT to MOSFET to conduct, you have to apply a suitable gate drive to the MOSFET. It is what is known as a synchronous converter. Yeah, there is a question, NPT IGBT or IGBT for solar inverter is my question. Don't worry, let's see whether we'll first we'll discuss the inverter. Let's see whether it has to block a negative voltage or not. And if it has to block the negative voltage, then we'll choose the appropriate device. Let us not discuss, or let us not try to find an answer to this question right now. First, we will see what sort of a voltage that device has to block in that solar inverter. If it has to block a negative voltage, then yes, you have to choose an appropriate IGBT,